What is up, YouTube? It's your boy Pizza back with a brand new video. And I'm sorry if I start coughing or whatever because I have a cold right now. But I will do my best. So, I'm going to be doing a mind cure mode in Madden. I was going to let you guys pick your position, but I didn't say that in my last video, so whatever. I'm going to be being a QB. And number. We will be number 5. I think. Or no, 3. We will be number 3. Personally, you already know what we're gonna go with. Pizza Man. Okay, so I did a fantasy draft. So we were just random. Okay, so we are on the field now. Oh, I look good in that uniform right there. I look amazing. Oh yeah, this is easy.
Thomas, the lone receiver left.
Hopefully we can come out of here.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And he's got Edelman for the first time. That's complete. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Brandon, when you have a player who could do that, that just makes your offense that much more dangerous. Being able to get outside the pocket, yet still keeping his eyes downfield and finding open receivers.
And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
I was going to go
really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab it.
Oh, Marius Thomas, stupid.
So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on it.
He's going
to
cut back right there. There we go.
To try and get his arms out of the sky.
And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line.
He's come a long way since his time at Georgia Tech. What did he run at Tech? He ran hitches and go routes, essentially.
Yeah.
I mean, but he ran them really well. He averaged well over 20 yards a catch while he was there. And he still creates downfield in the NFL. That big body and that willingness to go catch the football. He's pretty impressive.
And his friends call him Bebe. The nickname his uncle gave him back in the day. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
They just
the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws. Handed it to their guy who could run it. Created some space, and he got there.
So now it's first and goal. Trying to punch it
in. Touchdown, let's go.
And he's going to ball his way in for a Panther score. Jonathan's
great confidence having scored the last time out.
My line needs to block him. Oh, this is not good.
Thomas, the lone receiver left. Back to throw now on second and 10.
No one is even
on the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
He just stopped and let him go to the
All right, say it with me now. There's a lot of different words we come up with. Maybe has every move in the book and continued to get better throughout his career so he can make that type of a catch. One of the things that's really difficult for an offense is often identifying how to block a 3-4 defense. Well, when they're coming on a blitz, even more difficult. They're elusive targets and hard to hit.
Okay. That's where they kind of cross. So I'm hoping we can get some confusion and I get one of them open.
They're going to look to throw.
If I even have time. There we go.
To the right side, and he's got Edelman. And he's going to get this one down right to the edge of the...
And that conversion, oh boy, it's been good.
Julian Edelman. Now, I'm going to try to hit...
They come out here in the eye. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10.
No one's even near him.
That's caught. It's Thomas. And eventually stopped just shy of the coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let them know that that receiver.
With my good friend Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you. It's the Panthers in possession of the football as we begin quarter number two. And they've got it here with a first down. Thomas, the lone receiver left. They go
touchdown.
And a short run there for a touchdown.
Pizza man.
Bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with.
No,
I think pressure's always the first
one. Pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. That
there
one goes
go.
For 24
just wide
yards.
Open. As long as I wait a little bit,
have
to just
earn
be wide
veteran receiver.
Line is
defensively as they sack him for a loss of nine.
And the Broncos go to a nickel set on third down.
Yeah, they've got an extra DB out there. And he's got some space here. There goes
touchdown.
Jonathan Stewart. Touchdown,
let's go.
Carolina. Jonathan Stewart. A reminder coming up at this and every
there
halftime this season,
it.
We'll be checking in with Larry Ridley in Orlando for highlights and analysis of our first half.
LR, that's my
and
man.
Demaryius
that's your
Thomas
guy.
Okay.
On a crossing route, he hits Demaryius Thomas. And he'll be taken down, but
pizza
not before
nine
he gets
for,
into
nine
enemy
for 13,
territory.
Like
so in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And is it 100?
Carolina getting set to take the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there.
Nice.
That
right
could change
there.
Things in a big way. I say
oh,
go ahead,
catch
take
that?
The knee, get on out for the half. We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Thomas, the lone receiver left. Back to throw. Sliding out of the pocket.
Just chuck it down
now
there.
On the run, he'll throw it back deep.
Oh, you got to
catch
that.
He was looking for Julian Edelman that time. Right. Third down here.
Well, partner, I guess that answers the question about whether they're going to sit on it or not.
It does. Now we'll see if they try that again.
Yeah, I think what we find on plays like that, when you take that shot, if you're unsuccessful, then you go way more conservative to finish the half.
A battle for it, and it's picked off by Dominique Rodgers-Cromartie. And the possession is theirs at
one-handed, too. Is there an instant? Oh, we can't.
Their own 43-yard line. Maybe he telegraphed it a little bit right there. You've got a cornerback knowing that he's going against a rookie quarterback. He stepped in and picked it.
You think he had a great week
of
preparation,
Odell right there.
Looking forward to this opportunity? And the second part of that is when you're a young quarterback, you are going to stare down targets, but oftentimes your playbook has an experience.
Well, this started out really good.
Looks
for
like
us.
The defense in press and coverage here.
Two interceptions. Right off the bat.
Now a play fake here on first down. Backing up.
He's going to hit Demaryius
right
Thomas.
Side. That's complete Demaryius Thomas.
Oh, it's a
and
cute.
He'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Love the call by the offensive coordinator. Recognizing
go.
The situation very well.
Demaryius
calling for the play action pass and
game.
Completing it.
I'm going for 400. 400 yards.
They'll look to throw here on first down. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Well, sometimes
no
you just take things into your own
time.
Hands, don't
I
you? I mean, the offense is really struggling
two.
In this game. They're the ones keeping things going. They have to continue to play at that level.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down.
Jason Witten. Oh,
and that
my.
One is
you
incomplete.
Have to
he just dropped
right
it.
There.
But they're up big on the scoreboard, so maybe he can chuckle about later.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
Looking to throw.
Oh, they're wide.
Complete
oh, go.
To Jason Witten. And he is out of bounds inside the 35.
There are so many things to watch for when
go.
You play defense. and reading your keys. You always hear about that and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. They get 17 down to the 17, and it's a first down.
I know they don't like to hear it when they get to a certain age, but then you have to start to use your skills, your wiles, right? Your mind to beat guys to the football. And getting your toes tapped in bounds definitely qualifies as that, doesn't it?
The veteran showing he still has the agility.
We're going to go right across the middle to Gordon.
They go play action here on first down.
It's gonna be wide open.
That is caught.
Touchdown.
And he's brought down.
Oh, there's a flag. Flag is going to be holding.
Holding. Yep.
Marcus Williams, you can't grab on.
It's one of those ones that is so hard to judge, but defensive holding there, that's what the referee saw.
Oh, now they're going to boo him. Are they going to be booing even
they
more?
They come out here
to the other.
Now back to throw. And for
yeah.
the third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked up by the linebacker, Paul Warlow.
Right there,
and
he just
turned
over right
there as his guys will get the football back.
And
they needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the third quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get.
And they made a field goal.
Now the Panthers offense, they get set to come back onto the field. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things.
God. Blitz coming and down he goes.
What is this?
They bring the safety on the blitz and he busts through to drop
what even happened when we drafted
loss.
Our line?
Oh, free safety blitz. That can be a gamble, but it proves fruitful there.
Yeah, you're exactly right about the gamble because oftentimes the free safety is the last line of defense against a long pass. And when he comes at the quarterback, he better get home and make the play. Otherwise, a big play could result for the offense.
A really nice gain of 25 yards. And now a first down following that long gain.
And when an offense is doing a nice job selling the play action pass, a lot of responsibility shifts to the linebackers.
Maybe?
They're the ones that have to determine run or pass and
no.
get to the.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception.
What is going on?
By Dominique Rodgers Cromartie. He's now thrown four.
You know what? The good thing about this is I can say that I'm going to lead the league in interceptions.
Carolina getting set to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't
there
affect
we
me.
Go.
Just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on.
He's got it for a
touchdown.
Josh Gordon from 8 yards out. And thanks to the interception, the Panthers offense cashes in with six. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
That was a great catch right there.
Field, here come the Panthers. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. His throw incomplete.
Pass that.
Demaryius Thomas, the intended receiver, and now it's third down.
That's a nice play by Dominique Rodgers Cromartie. Excellent body control, a tall corner. Who often has to really do a great job of bending his knees to stay with his receivers. He just did a nice job there. The man they call DRC got a PBU for pass pro.
Here come the Panthers. Panthers now set to take over on offense. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
And he's hurt.
Now it looks like we've got a Bronco that's banged up on the play. Huh, hate to see this. Week one of the season. We'll be back.
I think he has a severe, whatever that word is. He's a
urinosa. And the next snap coming inside the red zone here.
Oh, he's injured. Oh, they had a
to throw now on first down.
I was like, oh, he's injured. And he's
flushed out right. And nearly another interception. They've been around the ball all game.
A missed opportunity for an interception would have killed off a drive. They had a chance there to finish things off. Didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys do not play offense.
Thomas, the lone receiver left. Being chased out left.
Oh, Julian Edelman
and
is
he's
open.
Got it. Touchdown, Panthers. Julian Edelman from 13 yards out.
Why'd you be hugging me?
And
don't
the Panthers
me.
Have got it on cruise control.
Look at this dude.
There's no doubt.
Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here.
5 minutes left.
They come out here in the eye. They'll start the drive with a run by Stewart. Not much there. Maybe a couple up to the 35. The linebacker, Koamisi, brings him down.
He's like a 38.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
No, actually, Stewart on this
on first down.
There you go.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 11 yards on the pickup, and it'll be a Carolina first.
Well, I'd say that run's pretty emblematic of what we've seen all day long. No matter what they've done on offense, this offensive line has controlled the line of scrimmage, giving them time to throw it, run it, do whatever they wanted. That's why their points up on the board. And right now, the psyche of the offense. We're in control, and we can do whatever we feel like doing out here on the field.
400 yards,
go ahead,
just like
ball,
I want.
Man. You got the big lead. You got the clock on your side. Obviously, they don't care much about the feelings of the other team, do they?
Well, I was going to say, you better run to the locker room pretty quick after this one.
Well, right now, maybe they're just looking at it from the fantasy perspective. More points for everyone if they win big.
19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it first and goal.
And they just had another big completion there. And I think in days gone by in the NFL, you might have asked, is this a little bit of overkill? Is this rubbing it in? I don't think people feel the same way nowadays.
It's the age-old argument. Then you could say on the other side, if you're going to get angry about it, stop it, right?
Go ahead and stop me. And I think a lot of the times they just...
Touchdown.
He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Demaryius Thomas from 4 yards... Panthers coming out now. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And incomplete. Probably should have had that one, but with the game he's having tonight, maybe they'll let it go.
My high school coach, John Ford, used to say all the time, if you're in a bad situation, laddie, don't compound it with a bad decision as well. And I think that's what we just saw there. Harassed in the pocket, and he throws into double coverage anyway.
He called you laddie?
He called me laddie, and that was the nicest thing he called me. Anytime the ball's thrown in the middle of the field, it's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
Got it.
This will be caught.
Touchdown.
At about the three. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina.
Let's go. I'm having a monster game. We get the ball.
Carolina getting set to take the field. Thomas, the lone receiver left. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. On the crossing route, he hits Demaryius Thomas.
To the house.
And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this.
Absolutely are destroying it.
So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now a play fake here on first down. Oh, look at Thomas wide open. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. A very solid gain of 27. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
And you know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had to pass protect pretty well, too.
Oh, everyone no, they haven't. Dialed in. They haven't. Nope. I just threw the ball right away.
On second down, they run with Stewart. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. Only a gain of a couple there. That leaves him needing about seven here on third down. Defense looking to hold serve one last time here on third and seven.
I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. These short ones still have their value. You can still set up to play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
So another catch, more yards, and now enough yards to break the single game record.
It seemed inevitable the way this game went that the yards record would fall, and we got to see it. We got to witness it, and the crowd is so excited to watch another NFL record fall.
Wait,
and
to broke
me,
it.
That touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher. The
me or Demaryius Thomas? Oh, we get the ball with 13 seconds left.
Thomas, the lone receiver left. He'll drop to throw. Buying time to his left.
He's gonna
and now he'll let
there.
This one go deep. Back over the middle.
You gotta catch
and
that.
It's incomplete.
He had
still throwing
hands.
To the very end. But now this game is over. Well, my friend,
we
for the
end up winning this one. Oh, I actually had 497 yards, 5 touchdowns. That's not bad. Okay, guys, thank you for watching this video. Make sure to get like spam that thumbs up button, you know. Subscribe if you want more of these videos. I also do NBA 2K17. And I'm out. Peace.